So John is looking at Jesus Christ's feet, and he said his feet is like brown grass, right? So what color is the rest of his body? April fell off the horse. April fell off the horse. Watch this. Read it again. Read it again.
Y'all take the nigga to the
ritual. And his feet.
Come on. Like
grass.
They didn't
Teaching our people the truth.
We are the Israelites according to the Bible.
That's right.
That is who we are.
You know why black men kill each other? Because they don't see each other as Jesus Christ.
We are Israelites from the time of Jesus. Let's look to Hebrews 7-14.
Because they don't see each other as Jesus Christ.
Y'all
want to
see the
Say, you ain't got to be nervous. We're the same people.
That's right.
We're brothers. Y'all can come on around. All right, watch this. So what we went over just now, right, is a little history. Did you hear it at all? No? Okay. So we're going to start back over. So let me ask you, what is your nationality? You say Christian? Now, hold on now. That is a religion, right? That is a religion, right? So, not your religion, but what is your race? Let me use that.
Oh, African-American.
African-American, right? Black? You say African-American, black, right? Now, where does the term, I got you, where does the term African-American come from? Because if we know our roots, right, and we claim to be African-American, where does the term African-American come from? You don't know? Let me help you out. African-American comes from two European men, one named Leo Scipios Africanus, right? That's where the term Africa comes from. The other one is, what's the other one? Amerigo Vespucci, right? Where they claim to found or discover this side of the world, right? Where the so-called Native Americans, they was already living here, right? And he named this land after himself, America. And in 1985, Jesse Jackson, right? Jesse Jackson, in 1985, he took those two terms and placed it on our people. So let me ask you, sis, and what's your name, by the way? April. So April, once we got to America, they labeled us African-American black. What were we called before even coming to America?
I don't know.
You don't know, right?
You
said what?
I don't know. Okay. I heard that we've been called Jews.
You heard that we've been called Jews? Where you heard that from? Many, plenty people? Okay. Now, a lot of times before we... Right, Jesus' people was the Jews, right? But what color was they? Uh-oh. It don't matter what color they was? So, April, and I want you to read along with me. Watch this. April, so if April, you're a black woman, right? If I went to somebody and some murder crime happened to you, you want justice, correct? So if I come to somebody and say, yeah, April was a white woman, she had long blonde hair, would you want somebody to tell them that about your murder trial? You want the right description, right? You don't want the right description? You don't want no justice?
I have to see a white description.
No. Right description, right? Okay, so your color would matter in that point, correct?
Yes.
Right. So watch this. Hold that. 2 Corinthians 11:4. Let's touch on that first. Let me show you that the color matters in the Bible, okay?
Okay,
all right, watch this. Let's go to 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 4. Because a lot of people might say, nobody seen Jesus. Nobody know what color he looked like. He's all colors. He looked like olive, right? But watch this. Let's see what the Bible says, go ahead.
The book of 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 4. For if he that cometh preacheth another Jesus.
Hold on. Paul said, somebody's going to come and try to teach you of a different Jesus than what the Bible originally says, right? So, in order to find out what the real Jesus looked like and to not be deceived, we got to know how the real one looked like and the fake one looked like, right? Watch this, keep going. Whom we have not preached, and the apostles never preached of this Jesus that's going to come, right? Go ahead. Or if you receive another spirit, meaning another understanding of the Bible or what the real Christ taught, go ahead. Which ye have not received, or another gospel. Another gospel, because one of the gospels on the earth is all nations can be saved, right? The Israelites are no more. The laws are done away with. Those are other doctrines or gospels that this false Jesus teaches. Go ahead.
Which ye have not accepted. Ye might well bear with him.
Bear with him meaning you're going to deal with that doctrine. You're going to correct that doctrine. That's what it means by bearing with him, right? So, let's see what the real Jesus looked like according to the Bible. Let's go to Revelations chapter 1, verse 1. Oh, this is where Christians say, oh, you got to stay out of Revelations. You got to stay out of them, right? Well, we're going to go straight to it. Watch what the Bible says.
Bring it out.
The book of Revelations chapter 1, verse 1. The revelation of Jesus Christ.
So the root word of revelation means to reveal. This is the revealing of the real Jesus Christ. Right?
Which God gave unto him to show unto his servants things which must shortly come to pass.
So these are things that must shortly come to pass. The revealing of the real Jesus Christ. Right?
And he sent and signified it by his angel unto his servant John.
So he sent this revelation of Christ to his servant John, right? And what did John do with this revelation of Jesus Christ? Read verse 2.
Verse 2. Who bear record of the word of God?
So April, what does bear record mean? We're going to get to it, but what does bear record mean? Okay, if you had the... You said witness? There you go. April on fire today. So, it means to, bear record means to write down something you see, right? To record something, correct? So, John recorded what he saw or the revelation of Jesus Christ. Now, let's see what John actually recorded. Let's jump down to verse 14. The real image of Jesus Christ, correct?
Verse 14. His head and his hairs were white like wool.
That's heavy right there. It said his head, meaning the hair on his head, and his hairs, meaning his beard, because Christ had a beard on. And the proof that is when he was going to get crucified, the people plucked off his beard, right? So Christ's head, the hair on his head and his beard, it was white like wool. April, help me out. What people have wool hair? Black people, right? Now, hold on now. Nobody seen Jesus, right? But we're getting a description of Jesus, right? Now, watch this. I'm going to show you that the color matters. So his hair, the texture of his hair was woolly, right? Go ahead.
As white as snow.
And the color of it was white, just like the brother next to you showing you the Bible. Go ahead.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
That means the whites of his eyes was like a flame of fire because he drank wine, right? You drink wine, the whites of your eyes turn red. Now, let's see about the color, go ahead.
And his feet,
like I see, April, I see your feet, right? Go ahead.
Like unto fine brass.
What color is brass, April?
Kind of like a bronze color.
There you are.
Brown,
goldish, bronze color, right? So hold on, I'm looking at your feet, right?
Orange.
Right, yours is bronze color, right?
No, my
feet are
brown.
Brown, right? Brown. Bronze, that's the same category. So the rest of your body is the same color as your feet, right? So John is looking at Jesus Christ's feet, and he said his feet is like brown, brass, right? So what color is the rest of his body? April fell off the horse. Watch this. Read it.
Y'all taking a consideration.
In his feet.
Hold on. Was like rash. They didn't never describe because his feet was.
Okay,
I got you.
I like it. I like it.
His feet was made of brass. Was the color of brass.
So his arms wouldn't be the same color?
Nope.
Okay, now hold it. Hold it. All right, you said might not, right?
He made all of us. He might be a very many colors.
Okay, let's see. We're going to see.
Just
we're
like
going to see.
Rainbow.
Watch this.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
Now, April, you said it might be the color of a rainbow. What man walk around here a rainbow color?
God ain't no man. He's the Holy Spirit.
Whew. Hey. All right, hold on. Look at this. I like it, though. Watch this.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
So he said his feet like fine brass. The color of his feet is brown. Go ahead.
As if they burned in a furnace.
They're so brown, it looks like it was burned in a furnace. If you burn anything in a fire, right, and it's come out burnt, what color is that, April? Anything.
It would come out burnt.
If it come out burnt, what color is something that's burnt?
It
would
be black.
It would be black, right?
And not necessarily, like, if we're being burnt, we'll be white, really. But when the skin come off, you ever seen a burnt victim?
Yeah, that's because the layer of your skin came off and it's going down to the white man. I understand that. But they don't say that he was physically burnt. That said, it looked like he was so brown, it looked like he was burnt up. So, what color is it describing Christ as?
His feet is
brown. She was about to say it, but she was listening.
No, because I ain't going to never say that because that's not what it says.
Okay,
it
says, now.
We only know the color of his foot.
Okay. Watch this. Let's see the. Let's get some more. Daniel 10 and 5 and 6. Let's see the color of his arms then. Since you want to set the feet, let's get the arms. Let's see. Daniel 10.
The book of Daniel, chapter 10, verse 5.
Now, April. You might not ever heard the Bible spoken the correct way, right?
Right.
So everything, and we don't blame our people, everything that we've been taught in this country is incorrect.
Right.
Now, when the Bible come out correctly, a lot of people might automatically start to force to try to go against it. But if you just sit there and really listen to what we're actually trying to show y'all.
The Bible now.
Huh?
I don't go against the Bible. I believe the Bible.
Okay, then. Let's see. Let's believe in this right here, great.
Then I lifted up mine eyes and looked, and behold, a certain man clothed in linen.
That certain man is talking about Jesus Christ. This is Daniel having a vision of Jesus Christ, great.
Whose loins were girded with the fine gold of Ephraim.
Now you see our garments? April, you see our garments, right? We have on a purple and gold girdle, right? But Christ had on a gold girdle, go ahead.
His body also was like the barrel.
It's still talking about his clothes. He had on a green garment, like the front of his Bible right there, right? It's a green garment, right? Go ahead.
And his face as the appearance of lightning.
Meaning his light, his face shine, go ahead.
And his eyes as lamps of fire.
That's saying the same thing in Revelation chapter 1. His eyes was like a flame of fire because he drank the wine in moderation. Go ahead. Now there you go. April, you say, and what's in that body, rest his body?
Fire from his eyes from drinking wine.
Yes. Yes. So we're going to go to the scripture to show you?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, let's go to Genesis 12 first and then Matthew 11 and 19. Yes, yeah. All right, April, if anybody drink wine, right, what color would it look? Why should their eyes turn? It turns red.
I didn't know that
because
I don't drink wine.
All right, that's fine. But if you ever see somebody drink, then why should their eyes turn red? Let's go to first Genesis chapter 49, verse 12. This is what Moses prophesied about Christ. Read.
The book of Genesis chapter 49, verse 12.
Go ahead.
His eyes shall be red with wine.
With what?
With wine.
So Christ's eyes was red with wine. This was a future prophecy, right? Now let's get the example in the Bible where he did drink wine. Go to Matthew chapter 11, verse 19. Let's get it.
The book of Matthew chapter 11, verse 19. The Son of Man.
The Son of Man, which is who, April? Who the Son of Man is? Now it said the Son of Man. Son. I know you're not a man, right? The Son of Man. That's talking about Jesus Christ, right? So the Son of Man, Jesus Christ, go ahead.
Came eating and drinking.
And what?
Eating and drinking.
So Christ came eating and drinking. Now listen to what the Pharisees said about Christ. What was he drinking?
And they say, behold, a man gluttonous and a wine bibber.
All right?
A wine bibber.
So Christ was drinking wine. And the prophecy was his eyes going to be red with the wine that he came and drank. So, Christ drank wine.
Right.
Now let's go back to Daniel chapter 10 and verse 6. So, now we know that Christ drank wine and the whites of his eyes was red. Now, let's get to that color, though. We got to get to that color. Go ahead.
The book of Daniel, chapter 10, verse 6.
Bring it out.
His body also was like the belt.
He had on a green garment, not a toga that you see, a green toga that you see in the movies. He had on a green garment, like we have on, good?
And his face as the appearance of lightning.
So his face is not talking about the color of his face, but his face had a light shining from it, good?
And his eyes as lamps of fire.
Because he drank wine, right?
And his arm.
And his head.
And his arm.
And his arms, April, go ahead.
And his feet.
And his feet, like it says in Revelation. Let's see what the Bible says.
Like in color.
Like a what?
Like in color.
Like a what?
Like in color.
Like in color, go ahead.
Like in color to polished brass.
That's brass burnt in the furnace. So Christ is a black man according to the Bible.
Brass man according to the Bible.
Yes.
It
says his face, his arms and his feet like a color to polished brass. You said brass is brown, right? A bronze color. Now, April said brown, bronze. She said all that.
I did not see brown.
Fine brass.
What color is brass, April?
Kind of like a bronze color.
There you are.
Brown.
Why you always lying? Oh my God.
That doesn't mean that he's black.
I know.
But even if he is black, that doesn't mean anything. Which I don't know what color he is. Even if he is a black man, he still, he don't got prejudice. He don't, that don't mean nothing. He don't hate white people. He made all of us. He's our creator. Oof. God is our creator. So how can he's the son of Jesus? So it really doesn't mean anything, y'all. It's like y'all coming over here teaching us that God is Jesus, that Jesus is black. Like it doesn't matter. Like that's not right. Because to a white person, how would that be? How would that make them feel?
Okay.
You're supposed to love everyone. You're teaching them, like, I feel like y'all teaching them, like, that only black lives matter. Just like, black lives is not the only one that matter. All lives matter. So.
Okay.
I understand that with y'all point.
Okay. You don't understand that point, right? The point is, go to Isaiah, is that 49 and 6? 49 and 6? Yeah. Yeah. It's a light thing.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 49, verse 6. And he said, it is a light thing that thou shouldest be my servant to raise up the tribes of Jacob.
No, raise up everybody.
To raise up the tribes of Jacob.
To raise up white people.
The tribes of Jacob.
To wake up Chinese people.
The tribes of Jacob.
Our job as the servants or the prophets, because like I said before, a lot of people, when we hear the real truth of the Bible, the real proper understanding of the Bible, we backbite against it, right? What you're going to find out, April, is the Bible was never sent to everybody.
Right.
God sent his prophets to go teach his people, not everybody, right? We don't finish that out.
And to restore the preserved of Israel, I will also give thee for a light to the Gentiles.
That or the Israelites that are being called and living as Gentiles.
That thou mayest be my salvation unto the end of the earth.
So the salvation is only for the Israelites. But let me show you who the Bible is given to. Because a lot of times, April, we may think that the Bible is universal. We think the Bible is for white people. We think it's for Chinese people, African people. Because y'all are not African. Y'all are the Israelites. You say everybody that believes in God? Listen to the Bible say. Go to Isaiah 55, 17. Let's see who salvation is for. Let's see. No, Romans. Romans. Everybody that believe? We believe what the Bible say, April. Romans 9, 27. Listen to what the Bible say, all right? This is the New Testament, right?
The book of Romans, chapter 9, verse 27. Isaiah also crieth concerning Israel.
So Isaiah is Isaiah, right? He also crieth concerning the Israelites. Not everybody, but go ahead.
Though the number of the children of Israel be as the sand of the sea.
Even though the number of the children of Israel be as the sand of the sea, because they always put out a census on our people, but God says you cannot number us, go ahead.
A remnant, shall be saved.
Of the children of Israel, a remnant shall be saved. That don't say everybody, April. Go to Romans 11 and 26. Watch what the Bible says, huh?
The book of Romans, chapter 11, verse 26. Uh-huh. and so all Israel shall be saved.
Read that again.
And so all Israel shall be saved.
Ooh, hey, April, that's what the Bible say.
All Israel.
The Bible says all Israel shall be saved, right?
All the people in Israel.
You said all the people. Oh, I caught it.
So what that supposed to mean?
You said all the people in Israel, right? See,
you're talking about the people, right?
I'm talking about the people.
All right.
So not the country. I'm talking about the people.
Before we get on the black part, right?
Let's show you that God's people do range from different colors, right? You get Hosea 7 and 8. I'm trying to think of the one in Jeremiah. I think it's 12 and... Might be 12 and 6. Get Hosea first. Perfect. Now, get that. That one better. So, watch this. Our people are different colors, right? Like, for example, you know Mariah Carey, right? Actress, singer. She's actually a so-called black woman because her father is black. So according to the Bible, she would be from an Israelite, according to the Bible. But she looks white, correct?
She looks mixed.
Okay. Cameron Diaz. Yeah, you know she looks white, right? But she's actually, her father is actually black. And you go by what your father is. So she's an Israelite, according to the Bible. Now watch this. Bob Marley. All black people listen to, right? Guess what his father is? His father is a white man.
Right.
So according to the Bible, he would be considered a white man. He's not an Israelite according to the Bible. Black people may look at the face, oh, he's black. But no, he's not black. Okay? Now, that's just now, like when you say the color don't matter, I agree with you 50%, but the other half, it does matter as well. Now, watch this.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 12, verse 9. Mine heritage is unto me as a speckled bird.
Hey, brothers, right here, y'all walking. Y'all are the Israelites according to the Bible, right?
That's right.
Y'all not just no black Negroes in the hood getting money. No, y'all are greater than that. Y'all are the chosen people of God.
Right.
And y'all must remember that. But go ahead, read that again.
I do believe that.
Okay, good. The book of Jeremiah, chapter 12, verse 9. Uh-huh. Mine heritage is unto me as a speckled bird.
You hear that? God said his heritage, his people, is like a speckled bird. I don't know if you know what a speckled bird is, right? Well, if you look it up on your phone, a speckled bird, it's the same type of bird, right? It looks the same, but it has different colors. They range in different colors, right? Some of the dots on it might be different. The color of its belly might be different, right? It's different colors. So, when you say the color of matter, I agree with you 50%, right? Because our people, like I give an example, Cameron Diaz, Mariah Carey, those are Israelites according to the Bible, but they look white. But then you got Bob Marley, who's not an Israelite, right? That's why we gotta do our research. We just can't come and say blurt out stuff that we hear. You gotta do your own research, right? Now go to Jeremiah 14:2.
You're right.
No. That do got something to do with the Bible. Because our people have a confusion of faces. So, Jeremiah 14:2. Watch this.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 14, verse 2. Judah mourneth.
It says Judah. Judah, right? If you look on the sign, put it right there. The tribe of Judah, according to the Bible, later on in history, April, the tribe of Judah name was changed to American Blacks. But the American Blacks, the original name is Judah.
Right?
Yeah. So I'm pretty sure the majority of everybody out here, y'all are Israelites from the tribe of Judah.
That's right?
But let's see what color the tribe of Judah primarily is, good?
Judah mourneth and the gates thereof language.
So it says Judah is in mourning. What people are in mourning? Are the Jews that's in the land of Israel today, the Jewish people, are they in mourning? Our people is in mourning.
Right.
Our people's in mourning, right?
Yeah.
So Judah mourns, great, it's closer to us.
They are black.
Oh, April. What does the Bible say the color of the Jews are?
They are black.
unto the ground.
God says the tribe of Judah is black unto the ground.
Right. That means different shades of brown, because the deeper you dig in the ground, the darker it gets.
Right.
Right. He's darker than you. You're a little bit lighter than him. The sister in the red shirt right there, lighter than all of us, right? We different shades of brown.
Right.
So-called Hispanics and Native Americans, people say, oh, they red. No, they're brown. That's a different type of brown.
Right.
Right? So our people vary from different colors. You understand what I'm saying? Now, so in that regard, color does matter, because the Jews are black according to the Bible. But the people in Israel call themselves Israeli or Jewish. They said they're the real Jews. But, matter of fact, let's see what the Bible says about them. Let's see what Jesus Christ, a black man, which we read earlier in the Bible, says about those people in the land of Israel today. In y'all stolen land. Watch this.
The book of Revelation, chapter 2, verse 9.
This is what Christ said about them.
I know thy works.
So Christ said, he knows our works, right?
Right.
And tribulation.
And tribulation means you're going through some hard times, right? So Christ said, he knows, the black Christ that the Bible says knows what his people is going through, right? He knows the police brutalities. He see the gang violence. He see the other nations killing our people. He's watching it. And he's proud of it, right? But he said, but he's long-suffering. He got to wait until the right time to come back to his father send him back. Oh, you got a question? Okay, I got you. I'm going to head back to you, right? Mm-hmm.
I know thy works in tribulation and poverty.
In poverty. Look around. Back to green. We are the ones in poverty. You got so-called white people coming around here all the time. Matter of fact, when he was down there, two white ladies rode on the window and went like this. How can you feel safe, all right? How can you feel safe, right? How do they have the ability to feel safe in y'all neighborhoods? Right? They're the people that destroyed y'all.
Right.
They're the people that brought y'all the slave ships on them ports down there in Charleston, South Carolina.
Teach.
And they ride through your neighborhood here.
But thou art rich.
But Christ said we are rich because the kingdom, the glory, everything was promised to us. Despite our condition, go ahead.
And I know the blasphemy of I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews.
So God says he knows the lies of those people who say that they are the Jews, but what?
And are not.
Hold on, Christ said there's people that's calling themselves Jews, but they're not the Jews. So we gotta know how the real Jews look like to know that the fake Jews look like, right? You already read that the Jews are black unto the ground. Christ is a Jew and he's black.
Right.
As if he's burning the fingers with white really here, just like the elder of our people, right? So if the Jews are black, but we got white people in the land of Israel, stolen land, I just thought that out there, stolen land from us, and we're white people, but the Bible said the Jews are black, then who's the people over there in that land? Then who the people over there in that land if Christ said they're not the Jews? They are not the Jews, they're Gentiles, they're heathens,
right,
according to the Bible. They are what God calls white people Edomites in the Bible.
Right.
Their forefather is Esau. Edomites, Esau. That's their forefather. That's who they descend from. Not Israel, not the Jacob. They don't descend from them, right? So the Israelites are us, April. We are the chosen people of God.
We used to scream black power while Haran was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.